Hello, dear subscribers and casual viewers of my Sultan TV channel. In today's video, I want to tell you about how the fate of Mahidevran Sultan turned out after the execution of Shehzade Mustafa. From this video, you will learn what tests she had to go through and how her life ended. Mahidevran Sultan became the wife of Suleiman when he was Shehzade and ruled in Manisa. It was there that in 1515 she gave birth to his son Mustafa. The Venetian ambassadors who were then in Istanbul did not hesitate to talk about Suleiman's personal life in their reports. So all of Europe became aware of how happy he was with Mahidevran exactly until another concubine, Hürrem, appeared in the life of Suleiman. A real struggle broke out between women. Quarrels constantly arose on the basis of jealousy. Valide Hafsa Sultan tried to keep calm in the harem as much as she could. But in 1533, there was a big scandal. There are rumors that Mahidevran beat Hürrem. As the mother of the eldest heir, she managed to avoid severe punishment. She left for Manisa with Mustafa, and after that Mahidevran never returned to Istanbul. It is worth noting that Mustafa was the third son of Suleiman, but his elder brothers, Mahmud and Murad, died during a smallpox epidemic in 1521. So Mustafa became the first heir to Suleiman, and it was he who was supposed to get the Ottoman throne. However, fate had its own way. Accused of betraying the Sultan, Shehzade Mustafa was executed in his father's military tent. This happened on October 6, 1553. After him, all his sons were killed. The execution of Shehzade Mustafa was the beginning of violent unrest among the Janissaries and the people. There were even several uprisings of false Mustafa. It is written in history that Mahidevran Sultan was involved in one of these uprisings. Thus she wished to avenge the death of her son. Shehzade Bayazid, who at that time fought for the throne, was accused of this uprising along with her. The body of the murdered Mustafa was sent to Bursa. Mahidevran, along with his daughters-in-law and granddaughter, were also sent there from Amasya. They were forbidden to leave the city limits. Moreover, Suleiman deprived his ex-wife of money and home. In Bursa, Mahidevran eked out her miserable existence without any money. She was doomed to poverty. The woman sold everything she had left. All their jewelry, clothes, and everything that had at least some value. She accumulated huge bts for the rent of the house in which she lived with her daughters-in-law and her granddaughter. Kamil Kapijioglu found a document in the Bursa, which said that the owners of this house complained to the court about Mahidevran. They demanded payment of the debt for 10 years. The court approved their request. According to a court decision, Suleiman's ex-wife had to pay 10 gold coins a day for 9 years and 6 months. The total amount for a long time was 34,000 gold and 200 akshi. Mahidevran constantly endured humiliation and insults. For many years she was called the mother of a traitor, she herself was called a traitor. The people of Bursa treated her disrespectfully. She herself was despised, and her people were driven out of the market. When she wanted to buy something, the seller specially served other buyers, and for her they sold stale and damaged goods. Mahidevran was tired of enduring this and complained to Kadi Bursa. And he decided that all butchers, grocers and other sellers were strictly warned to serve the people of Mahidevran out of turn and give out the best goods at the prices indicated in the document. And those who do not like it, he ordered to punish. All the torment of Mahidevran and her small family ended when Selim, the son of Hürrem, came to power. And all thanks to her granddaughter Nargisha, who maintained friendly relations with Nirbanu Sultan. Through her, Sultan Selim learned about the hardships of Mahidevran. He ordered to pay all her bts and appoint a salary, as a former sultana. Moreover, Selim bought the house in which the unfortunate woman lived for a long time. Thanks to the help of Selim, the mausoleum of Shehzade Mustafa was completed, in which Mahidevran Sultan later found her peace after the death. Mahidevran lived a very long life and died at the age of 80 on February 3, 1580. By the evil intent of fate, the woman outlived her own son Mustafa and all her enemies whom she had. She was able to live a very long but sad life. How do you think fate was fair to her? Maybe she deserved a much better fate. Please share your opinion in the comments. I thank you for watching. Give this video a like. Subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. and continue to stay with me so as not to miss new interesting stories about the Ottoman Empire. See you soon.